Hey guys, James here from the forums. This is your bush bum knot craft or rope craft. Okay, I'm gonna start teaching this, and I'm gonna teach this whole series as one long video with the knots in there, so you're gonna have to watch the whole thing. And then when you post your video, okay, and this is gonna be I would prefer a video submission over pictures. If you can only do pictures, I understand. I want good pictures. To make sure that you tie the knots and somebody else didn't tie the knots, and that you're able to tie the knots without staring at a book or watching a video. Okay, practice them and then record them. Don't just watch it once and then put the video on silent and record yourself or take a picture after doing that. You need to actually own this skill. This is one of those skills that can really, really help you out. So I'm going to start with what I believe is the most important knot, and I'm going to tie it the way I believe is the most important way, and that's the bowline knot. And the bowline knot is great for making a fixed loop that won't slip, but the best use for it, which is still making a fixed loop which won't slip, is as a self-rescue knot, tying the knot around yourself so you can be hauled out of water or a crevasse or things like that. You can be hauled up into a helicopter or pulled up by people. If you're, you know, stuck in the water, or you're stuck, you fall down a cliff, or you're stuck in a crack or a crevice, something like that. So that's how I'm going to teach it. I'll show it really slow, so I'll show you one time far away what the whole thing looks like, and then I'll get real close and show you. All right, here we go. The bowline knot. Okay. Make sure you guys can see. Sure you guys can see this. So we have the tag end and the working end, okay? And you should be able to tie this with one hand, which means that if your arm is broken, okay, all you need to do is be able to close your fingers, just keep the knot out, and you can even do it with your teeth, holding the rope in your teeth, okay? So here we go. We're gonna go under, make an X. We're gonna go through the X. We're going to go around over the tag end with the working end. Now there's a loop around my wrist, so we're going to go over the tag end, under the tag end, and pull through the loop and up. Just like this. And now you can be hauled up under your armpits. That's the bowline knot. So let's zoom in and do it, shall we? Okay. Here we go. All right, let me just make sure that you guys can see me. All right, here we go. So we've got our working end and our tag end. We're gonna make an X under the tag, so we're gonna go under the tag end, make an X, through the X. Okay, so here we are now. All right, let's do that again. Working end, tag end, make an X, through the X. Okay, working end, tag end. Over the tag, under the tag, and now the loop that I created on my wrist here, see the loop? I'm gonna pull the working end through the loop and tighten. This is how the bowline knot should work. You should have a little tag sticking on the inside of the loop. This knot will not slip. This is a non-slipping loop, which means that you can use it to haul yourself or someone else up into a helicopter or out of trouble. Okay? That's the bowline knot. I'll show you one more time. Here we go. Okay, let me put the camera down just a little bit. We're gonna go under and make an X, through the X. Okay, now we have a loop on our wrist. We're gonna go over the tag, under the tag, and we're gonna pull it through the loop. Tighten, And there it is. That's the bowline knot. Now, you could tie this as a much smaller loop and use it to run around a tree for a ridgeline or for any various number of things where you would need a fixed loop, securing a load possibly. But the most important use, in my opinion, is to save yourself. All right, guys, that's the bowline. Stay tuned for the next knot.